guys, thank you so much for hopping on this YouTube video. I hope this video inspires you and uplifts you in some sort of way. The topic of this video is how to become savage. What do I mean by that? Is at the end of the day, if you're going through a rough patch inside of your life, whether it's because of finances or you're going through a really hard breakup, I think that this video is gonna inspire you and motivate you and uplift you in so many different levels and so many different ways. And I'm gonna give you great tips on how you can become savage inside of your life to take more control of your mental headspace and emotions when shit hits the fan. When shit hits the fan in your finances, when shit hits the fan in your relationship, or you know, you go through a breakup, or you're going through just a rough patch inside of your life, how can you become savage? And what I mean by savage is being more control of your thoughts and your emotions and not letting the outside world affect you so heavily and so deeply. So let's get into it. So the first thing that I wanna say on how you can become savage is, number one, be more aware of your attachments that you're having with inside of your life. Whether that be attachments with people, whether it be attachments with the stories that you're clinging on and you're playing over and over like a broken record inside of your head. Because a lot of times, the reason why we feel so much pain, whether it be pain and disappointments, pain in, you know, being hurt and anger and frustration, all this, these negative vibrations, negative energies, because we're so attached to a story that our ego attached ourselves to, or we're attached to a person that our ego attached to that person, right? And I'll make some great examples is that a lot of times with us, we attach these expectations, right, that we have on these people. And then through these expectations, we create a story with the expectations with these people, or expectations on a situation that you, let's say you really want that job and you expected that it's gonna go exactly this way and it didn't end up going that way. And instead of being open to see the brighter sides of things, you're so stuck on that story you created inside of your head about that circumstance or about that situation. The same thing with an experience with a breakup, right? That you won't look at the bright side of that breakup and the end of the day saying, okay, maybe that person was toxic for me. Maybe they weren't good for me. Maybe there's better out there. You're not gonna look at the positive. You're gonna be so, a lot of times we attach ourselves, our ego attaches to ourselves to these stories of that person. Oh my God, they were perfect for me. You know, we had so much good time. And you're so clinged on to the good times through those stories, but you're not remembering the bad times. You're not remembering the toxic things and why you guys are just not good with each other. And this is what I mean about attachment to stories and people and having that expectations. So the expectations, it goes from having expectations, then the expectations turn into attachments, and then the attachments turn into these stories that now with the stories, then the attachment, you're clinged on to that and it's hard to let it go. So then now what that does is that it causes you stress, it causes you anxiety, it causes you frustration, it causes you anger, it causes you all these crazy deep emotions that, you know, is really wearing you down. So when I say how can you become savage, is savage in the sense that you're savage where it's just like, nah, I can overcome that. I can overstand that. I'm not gonna let that break me down. I'm not gonna let that beat me up. Why? Because you're learning how to not have expectations on people and situations. Because at the end of the day, I always say it in all my videos, you came in this world by yourself, you're coming out of this world by yourself. Nobody owes you shit. I don't care if it's your auntie, your uncle, your parents, nobody owes you anything, right? At the end of the day, it's you owe, the only person that owes you anything is you. You're responsible for you and you alone. And then as you work on you and as you level up mentally and emotionally for yourself, then you could be of service to other people out there, right? Instead, it's so easy for us to focus on the outside world all the time, focus on doing this for that person, doing that for that person, doing that. And then we put these expectations that those same people, because we're focusing so much, this is why it hurts so much when you have expectations on other people and they don't follow, they don't grow up to that expectations, why it hurts us when that doesn't happen. Number one, it's because we are trying to replace by having that expectations on those other people, having those expectations on the situations, the emptiness that's with inside of ourselves, and we want that situation, we want that person to fill that emptiness with inside of us. So then we have this expectations, it's easier to, again, look outward than it is to look inward. So then we put all these expectations and all this stuff like that, stories we create about outside of us that we're not being able to focus inside. So when those expectations don't follow through, then we're stuck with looking inward and feeling those emotions inward because that expectations we had outside of us didn't fulfill that emptiness we're feeling within. Boom. So this is why we get so hurt from those expectations. So if you're able to stop focusing outside of you and now focus inside of you, take all that focusing, you're focusing on that expectations of that person, that expectations of that situation, and fill your cup and make sure that this is feeling whole and complete. And that goes into number two, to becoming savage. Then you will no longer hurt and feel so much pain when those people and situations don't follow up to your expectations. So that's number one in turning into savage, right? Number two is learning how to feel whole and complete with inside of yourself. What that means is at the end of the day, if you don't need any person, you don't need any situation, you don't need that money, you don't need the material things, you don't need that person to make you feel whole and complete, that you're already whole and complete within yourself. So then that other stuff outside of you is extra comparison to what you already have with inside of you. Because if you can really tune in to that wholeness within you, meaning everything else will flow to you effortlessly in the way that you want it to, because you already provided it for yourself. A lot of times we are seeking so many things outside of us and putting expectations on other things outside of us and getting our feelings hurt and all these headaches and situations happening to us. Because at the end of the day, we're trying to fill a gap with inside of ourselves that nobody else and no money, no material things, no person can fix until you look inward and fix it inside of yourself. Because God created us whole and complete, meaning that we are abundance of love. We are abundance of prosperity. We are abundance of happiness. We are abundance of everything else. But for such a long period of time, and how we were raised and how society raised us and showed us, is that we need the exterior things to make us feel whole and complete. And that is not true, right? So we lost touch with that wholeness with inside of ourselves. So that's why to really become savage, you need to understand that you are whole and complete with inside of yourself. To become savage is understanding that you don't need anything else outside of you to make you feel good about yourself. And once you can not put expectations on other people, there's no room for disappointment. There's no room for disappointment and, oh, that situation didn't fall through. It is what it is, right? Number three, understanding that life does not happen to you, life is happening for you. So at the end of the day, when that person, that situation doesn't follow through for you, you're gonna understand to look the bright side of things. That looking at the bright side of things, there's no attachments. So you're not gonna be disappointed, you're not gonna feel sad, you're not gonna feel anxiety, you're not gonna feel angry, right? You took away all those negative feelings because there's no attachments. Then now, without those attachments, and with you feeling already whole and complete with inside of yourself, so you're no longer lacking anything, you're able now to heal quicker from those situations, from understanding that life is not happening to me, life is happening for me. So now you start looking at life as that, oh man, that was a great learning lesson. I'm so grateful that that person walked out of my life. I'm so grateful that I didn't get that opportunity, because I know I'm 100% positive I'm making space inside of my life when things get taken away or things don't go my way. It's because the universe has better for me. It's because God is preparing you to see if you are ready, that you learned valuable lessons to obtain bigger and better things that you probably can't even imagine that is waiting on the other side for you, right? So that's how these three steps, you guys, is helping me to become super savage, to be super uplifting when bad things hit me or things don't go my way, how to stay out of that negative vibration to stay high and stay in good vibrations. Because when you're in good vibrations, you attract way more to you. You're like a magnet for abundance of great things to come to you because you're on such a high vibration. Low vibration, you're literally blocking your blessings and you're staying stagnant, right? Because you're not giving yourself any room. You're not making space in anywhere of your being to make room for new to come in because you're so caught up and clinged on to those stories and you're so caught up and clinged on to the negativity. So make room today and become savage. And literally you will see these couple steps that I shared with you will change your mental headspace like this. And you'll start feeling so uplifted to know that life is not happening to you, life is happening for you. And you're just making great room for greater to come in that you can't even probably imagine. So make room for those great things to come in. Make room to be happier. Make room to forgive people. Make room to start making yourself feel whole and complete with inside of you. Because all these things I'm sharing with you is doable. It just takes time and it takes effort. And you are well worth it to put that time and that effort into yourself every day as you wake up. I say in all my videos, you guys, each one teach one, share the love, share the knowledge. So if you have found great value in this video, if you have found that this, woo, I'm fired up just talking to y'all. So you gotta be fired up watching this. So if this is firing you up in some sort of way, share this great vibration, share this good energy, share this love with somebody else that you know that can find value in hearing what I just, and let's create a whole army of savage people who are more happier, who are more one with themselves, who are more whole with themselves. And let's keep wising up and rising up. You guys, if you guys have not joined the Wise Up, Rise Up community, you go check it out on Facebook. I have a Facebook group called the Wise Up, Rise Up Facebook group. I have my Wise Up, Rise Up podcast to keep you inspired and uplifted that drops every Thursdays on Anchor and Spotify. And then I also have an amazing TikTok which shares a lot of relationship contents with whether it be quotes or great value to keep you inspired and motivated in any type of way in what you're going through. If you're going through a breakup with a relationship or in a relationship, go check that out as well, you guys. I'll leave it in the comments. And leave me your thoughts. Leave a comment. Tell me what your thoughts on this video is. If it inspired you and uplifted you in some sort of way, let me know what you think. Give me a thumbs down. Give me a thumbs up. See, my thumb doesn't even want to go down. Give me a thumbs up. Give me a like, you guys. And if you have not subscribed to my YouTube channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button to stay inspired and to stay uplifted and keep wising up and rising up each day. All right, take care and I'll see you guys in the next video.